What's up, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Depeche Mode, and we're back with another tune from their opening album, Speak and Spell. I already reacted to, Puppets on this album, which I believe was written by Vince Clark, an early member of the group, founding member, and then also of Erasure and Yaz and other places. Nevertheless, this was an album that, as I mentioned at the time, was very crucial for me. It was the first one I bought. Now, I was buying this as like a 4 or 5 year old, so like 84, 85. It was a few years after it came out, but as I mentioned before, in my house, Depeche Mode and other 80s was often playing, and so some of the songs sort of caught my ear and, you know, made me want to go buy their albums for myself so I could kind of listen to it in my room and really like key in on the songs. And I do remember this song, Photographic, really catching my ear, which is interesting to me for a number of reasons. Like, one, it really does have a sort of an intense, energetic sound, a darker sound, so it's interesting to me in that regard. But secondarily, you know, if you know this channel, you probably know that I'm a techno DJ, I'm a hardcore DJ, I mix a number of different kinds of electronic music. And I mentioned it before, I think listening to a number of bands in the 80s, but especially Depeche Mode and their excellent keyboard synths and their like excellent drum machines, use of drum machines and, you know, incorporation of like industrial like sounds within the percussive rhythms and so on, I really think it primed me to like techno, especially, you know, about a decade later when I discovered it in about 96, 97. So, you know, I think Depeche Mode has been crucial to me, not only just enjoying the band itself, but I think in a way it set me on a musical journey that took me to some other places because of their work. So, you know, they're just a huge influence on my life, especially musically. And since Andy Fletcher passed, it just occurred to me, like, you know, I really want to pay tribute to that. And I feel like some people have reacted to the videos already and they're enjoying it. And I feel like there's no better time right now than to celebrate, or than right now to celebrate Depeche Mode and their awesome music. So like I said, we're going to go way back to the beginning. We're going to actually listen to a tune, as I mentioned, Photographic, that was released on some other label. There was some label in 1980, they released a compilation of music that wasn't produced or copyrighted by their label. They just like put a bunch of other songs that like somehow they had gotten access to on a release and put it out. And Photographic from Depeche Mode was on there. So yeah, again, I don't think that was, you know, I don't think they were licensed to do that, but nevertheless, this does, in a way, mark the recording debut of Depeche Mode, and then it was later re-included, of course, on their opening album. So here we go. This is Photographic by Depeche Mode on Speak and Spell 1981. Oh, I should mention, I almost forgot, and I think that's partly why. I usually talk about the lyrics before I let the song rip. This one, I'm actually sort of in the dark, if you will, in the dark room. The choruses seem straight enough, they're just very simple, and they're about being in a dark room with the bright light and you're developing film. And, you know, there's lines like, I take pictures, photographic pictures, and because of the sonic atmosphere of the tune, it does feel like maybe there's a suggestion that these are erotic photos, or at least photos with sexual content of some kind, and maybe I'm reading into the lyrics a little bit, just because there are so many Depeche Mode songs that deal with sex and the psychology of sex, but yeah, that was sort of, you know, maybe not right away. Like, again, as a little kid, I really just keyed in on the sonics, the keyboard use, the drum machines. I really loved the sound. As I got older, I started paying attention to the lyrics a little bit more. And I just remember thinking this was about, like, photography, and maybe there was a sense that they were naughty photos. But it's weird because the verses, there's two, like, notable verses. And I'm not sure, like, the first one seems like maybe it's talking about the way, like, a photograph, it's a representation of someone, but it's not them, right? Like, the material is used to recreate an image, and so that image is there on the photograph, but, like, it's not actually them. But, like, I don't even know if that interpretation is spot on. But then the second verse, like, totally goes in a different direction. It's saying something about, like, I'm waiting to the day when I can mesmerize the light, and I'm spending my time thinking about some memory that we both, like, used to know, or something like that. And then I forget what the line after that is, but it's, like, basically it seems to run in a different direction from the first verse. So if anyone out there knows a better sort of understanding of what the song is about, please let me know, because
Yeah, I can tell it's about photography and developing and maybe the way in which, like, you then have an artifact which is a sort of two-dimensional representation of a person, but not actually the person. But yeah, beyond that, I think there's some things going on here that I'm not really understanding, or at least I don't know quite where they're going. So let me know if you do, but yeah, let's get to it. This is Photographic by Depeche Mode, Speak and Spell, 1981. Let's restart it, because I jumped the gun. Sorry. You hear that? Sort of melody. It's soft. And there's like a high, like, percussive cricket kind of like chirping. And all the while that steady bass line waiting for the kick is what I was going to say. And as I went to say it, there it was. Straight line for me between me enjoying this tune and eventually getting into techno and trance a decade later. The way that second verse comes in, this new melodic layer, the snare hitting right when the second verse started. I'm missing something, but let me know. That hard synth. And again, that really soft, high, frantic melody. Digital string melody on top of the more like kind of plucked digital melody, and then that hard synth element, it's just, it perfectly captures the vibe of the tune. And like dance to this at a nightclub. These little crickets, man. Almost have an acidic sound. Again, I know, like, I think a 303 was still in development at this point, so I'm not sure. I like that they let this one run. You know, it's not like an extended mix. This is a studio album version, and it just really lets this groove, this dark, mysterious sort of groove, just run. Just all the melodies now, all the sonics together. The high melody.
that like frantic one coming in a little bit louder there. The composition is amazing. Oh, and by the way, that tune's 41 years old. Just think about that. But it is interesting because, again, you could tell that, you know, even from their very first album, they were blending tunes, maybe not necessarily as a medley per se, but as a like solid work of art where, you know, they're individual stories, but it sort of blends into one larger sonic narrative. I love it. I really do like that tune. It's one of the very first Depeche Mode tunes that really kind of hit my brain and like, wow, their music is amazing. And it's funny because I remember listening to Master and Servant, and I really kind of like the like energetic sonics of that one too. I remember my sister saying, "Do you know what they're talking about?" I was like, "No." She just like laughed, and later I would understand what that sort of moment was all about. I really do blame Depeche Mode in the best possible way for making me interested in the keyboard music, drum machine music, and ultimately electronic music more broadly, which about a decade later would ultimately carry me into the world of DJing and techno and trance and hardcore and jungle and all sorts of sub-styles that still dominate my musical life today. So, like I said, big ups to Depeche Mode for being an amazing band that has carried an amazing sound in different iterations, different pathways, different variations, but have, you know, maintained a similar sort of sound and ethos despite the fact that they've gone down those different alleyways. And also big ups to them for sort of inspiring me to go on a musical journey that has taken me to some really cool places and met some really cool, in which I've met some cool people. So anyway, big ups to Depeche Mode. Let me know what you think. Let me know if there's another tune from Speak and Spell you'd like to hear reacted to. It'll always be very nostalgic for me. I mentioned before the first several Depeche Mode albums, which they're all up here if you can see them. Actually, I'm missing two. I'm missing A Broken Frame and Construction Time Again. But I am in the process of getting them. I mentioned I recently got the 2017 album with Where's the Revolution, so I'm going to react to that one soon. Keep an eye out. But yeah, ultimately, in particular, Speak and Spell, it's the first Depeche Mode I heard. It's some of the first music I remember, like, as a kid, as a human being. So it will always be very, very nostalgic to me. Let me know if you feel the same way. Other than that, I do appreciate the people watching and listening. Have a good day, have a good night, and I will see you next time. Peace.